Oh. Yeah. Yes, give me another skill. Ah, you suck. I was so close. Aloha, guys. How's it going? It's the Flying Hawaiian here, bringing you a new series today called Stories, The Path of Destinies. So, this is another free game that we get with PlayStation Plus, and I gotta tell you, it looked really cool when I first looked at it, just screenshots and stuff. I haven't played it yet, but I'm eager to get into it, so let's just go ahead and click X to play. Ooh. Oh. Alright, let's go to options. Dialogue volume, effects. Oh, right there. Subtitles, cool. Alright.
Once upon a time, the infamous rover Renardo plundered the floating isles. Then his mother called him to her deathbed. "Swear to me that you won't die on the gallows," she rasped. Reluctantly, he swore. And he whiled away his days at home with music, cards, and wine. But the Emperor had changed. He'd been good once, a shy, almost humble toad. He'd built universities. But then people started whispering about mass graves in the woods. Midnight rituals, victims screaming. The Imperial Ravens would round up entire villages, and no one ever returned.
Ooh.
The Ravens had come to Ubar scouting for ancient books said to be of great power. But the librarians had hidden the books, so they'd burnt the librarians. The citizens, outraged, had driven them off. The Ravens had come back with dropships. The kid had fled with one of those books. He was brave and dumb and wanted to join the rebellion. And Renardo had promised his mother he'd protect him.
Oh, Renardo. Why? Why make promises? Ooh. Floating isles. So not floating in the sea, but floating in the sky. That was cool. Little introduction bits. Let's see what happens here. Oh my gosh, for reals? Loading is real. Saving. Ah, you're saving. We are Renardo, the fox. For real?
The kid was looking down, watching his city burn. "Sorry, kid," Renardo told the kid. "Look, if we give them the book, they'll leave you alone."
"My mother died for this book!"
"I promised her I'd protect you." Oh, damn it. The kid had run off. With the book, of course. So Renardo had to run after him.
Okay. So top down type of game. Okay. Can I go this way?
Protect Peter. Current objective.
Alright. So let's just go ahead and take off. Can we jump? No. Jump. Okay, we have a hit.
The two ravens were staring at the kid like he was their dinner, which probably was what was in their tiny brains. "Hey," Renardo said. They cocked their heads at him. "Pick on someone as ugly as you." Wait, that didn't come out right.
"For the Emperor!"
The ravens cawed and rushed at him.
So they get a little bit of a hit. Oh. When an enemy is about to attack, L square. Countering can interrupt any other action. Okay. Ooh. Oh, You got me. Ooh, yes! Oh, that's really easy. Like, most of the time countering in games is like a hassle. Like dust. Countering in that game was a hassle.
A dropship flew overhead.
Oh, hide.
He hoped they hadn't noticed him. The kid.
It's like telling a story. I love it. I love my story. Hold square to grab. Aim, release to throw. Okay. You're off. You're off. Alright.
Oh, right. The Gate of Heroes. Someone's idea of a joke. Making the Skyship Docks a gated community. You needed a hero's sword to open it. And the kid was on the other side of the gate. Who let you through?
Promise me you'll take the book to the rebels. Or I'm gonna steal your ship.
I'm not taking the damn book anywhere. And neither are you.
Try and stop me, laughed the kid. I bet you don't even have a hero sword.
And with that, the kid hopped away.
Don't steal my ship.
Kid, he was an idiot, but he had guts. Where was Renardo going to get a hero sword?
Oh, how about from this chest right here?
Ore and wind essence? That sounds about right. I'll need a workshop, though. Perfect.
Oh, perfect. Okay, so these are little workbenches. Sword crafting. This is sword crafting menu. Here you can craft and upgrade powerful magic swords. Gather the required materials from the chest scattered throughout Boreas. Boreas? The selected sword's current level and special power. The selected sword's special power at the next level. The resources needed to upgrade the selected sword. So, you have enough resources to craft your first sword.
A hero sword. QED.
Ooh. Allows you to heal one. Also allows to heal oneself. It's level 2. Ooh. That's cool. Okay, so I assume we'll get into these. Look badass. Why, thank you. Okay, so we got a wind essence, but we need more ore. Okay, got a hero sword now. So chests are the only thing we can get essence from? What about this? What if I just hit this over here? Good thing there was this whole crafting station down there.
This is what he got for settling down and finding people to care about. The kid's mum had been a swell cook, and she'd laughed at Renardo's jokes, even when he didn't know he'd made one. And then the ravens had come to burn her. And she'd made him promise to protect the kid. But she never told him where the book was. Just the kid.
Gosh dang it. Why? Why did you do this, lady? Should have told me where the book was. Oh, I got hit.
He came up to a ledge. It was too far to jump. There'd been a bridge here before, hadn't there? And there was Peter, giggling at him.
How'd you get across? He asked the kid. Where'd you find a hook?
I harped, said the kid. Wise ass kid.
Hey, look out behind you.
Cute, said Renardo. Oh, ravens. It was time to talk some sense into the kid. Just hook his way across the ledge and chase the kid down. Thing was, he hadn't used his hook since he'd retired. How had he done it? Maybe if he meditated at that altar there, he'd remember his old skills.
Well, good thing that altar popped up. What's up, Alter? Skills. Each time you gain a level, you also gain a skill point. Spend your skill points at the altar scattered throughout Boreas to gain new powerful abilities or upgrade existing ones. Skill tiers. There are 4 tiers of skill. The more truths you discover, the more tiers you unlock. Okay. 1 truth revealed. Okay. Skill info. Here you can find the description of each skill and unlock requirements. Shield hooking. Hooking a shield-wielding enemy will rip away the shield, leaving him vulnerable. You have 1 skill point. Go ahead and buy the hook shot skill.
It was starting to come back to him.
Something oh yeah.
You never completely forgot, like how to freeze time when attacking. The more he fought, the more he'd probably remember.
Okay. Alright, so we just go over here, press triangle. Oh yeah, we did it. Oh yeah.
And there was the Farfarer. She was the fastest ship he'd ever known. She could do the Kessel Run in 12 furlongs. Well, so the salesman had told him. And something told him the kid was about to walk into an ambush.
Stop! He shouted. I'm not giving you the book! Shouted the kid, and took off. No! Peter!
But the kid ran for it. And a goggler nailed him with its ivy.
Oh. Sneaky, sneaky. Peter!
The book was unburned. Next to it were the buckles from the kid's shoes and a kid-sized pile of ashes. Damn it. Why hadn't he lied and told the kid he'd take the book to the rebels? The kid would be alive now. Really pissed off and betrayed, but alive. Oh, damn it. Renardo picked up the book. He couldn't let the Empire have it now. He was going to have to get it out of there. He'd be a wanted man. Probably have to join the rebellion just to have a place to dock. Well, he'd hated home life anyway.
Ooh. Okay. Okay. There's nothing over here. Can't. Oh, boxes. These boxes seem like they only contain health. Aw, oh, poor kid. Golly. Hitting you right in the heart spot. Right from the beginning. Ah! No, boxes can contain ore. That's what I wanted to know. So we break every box from here on out.
Okay. What I didn't get the big to see. Deal about this book anyway? Maybe he should open it and find out.
Maybe not. Maybe you should.
All that had been years ago. How many? The war was a blur. And now 3 Raven scout ships were chasing him.
Where are you running, rebel?
Cawed the Raven captain over the loudhailer. Renardo could see them cranking up their catapults.
Just going out for milk?
Renardo yelled back.
Where can you run?
Laughed the Raven horribly. Far behind him, another city was burning. The dark cloud above its island was thousands of Imperial ships. The fleet was doing a thorough job.
Mm-hmm.
Take us to the rebel base and we'll spare your life!
It cawed. The entire jury-rigged rebel fleet was only a few islands to the east. Beyond that were only the Pillars of Heaven. A sea of endless blood-colored tornadoes. The rebellion was out of time. Unless Renardo could bring a game-changer. Maybe. He could. Renardo had found out where he could find the pieces of the Sky Ripper, the legendary weapon that had exiled the lost gods. Surely a legendary weapon could win the final battle. On the other hand, his old friend Lupino had sent Renardo a desperate message saying he had a brilliant scheme to save the rebellion. If Renardo could only rescue him. Renardo dived the Farfarer towards the abyss. as he felt the heat of the jet stream. The Raven ships peeled off, not stable enough to follow him down there. Now it was time to choose. Lapino or the Sky Ribbon.
Oh, interesting.
We write the story.
You can't make new old friends. The Rebellion was out of time and Ronald became a game changer, even though Lapino wasn't what anyone would consider a game changer. He could come up with some harebrained schemes. Maybe rescuing was worth it. By first getting armature. I kind of want to meet his friend.
Ah, Lapino. Apparently, the Mad Rabbit had sold a Pegasus that he did not exactly own. Lapino always wiggled out of trouble, given time. But he was out of time. The Ravens had figured out that Lapino was a rebel spy. If the fleet reached him first, they'd string him up for that. Never mind the winged horse.
Let's go into a loading screen that's going to take 10 hours. So, pretty cool game so far. I'm liking it. So, I guess you'll honestly probably have to play it twice. I just hope there's no spots where you have to choose between like three options. That would kind of suck. Because then you have to play it three times and then who knows. But
Lapino had apparently managed to confuse the judge by arguing that he hadn't actually stolen a winged horse. He'd only sold it. But wait, where was the prison? The village was empty. Had everybody fled the Ravens? If I craft a sword now, it's going to be really short.
Gems? Gem socketing. This is gem socketing menu. Here you can equip powerful gems that will augment both your offensive and defensive capabilities. Your gauntlet has three sockets in which to put gems. Select one socket to see your gems. Each gem has three levels and its effect increases with each level. Picking up a gem you already have will automatically upgrade the gem's level. You can find gems in chests scattered throughout Boreas if you're lucky enough. Okay. So I'm assuming we'll find one here in a sec. Let's just see swords. So we can upgrade this. We can build different swords. Okay, interesting. Okay. Pretty cool. We don't have enough for anything yet. Can I break that? Nope. Oh, what's this? Okay.
No skateboarding, the sign said.
Oh, I feel like I missed my opportunity to go. Oh. Some ravens. Lots of ravens. Ravens everywhere. I'm gonna kill you guys. You guys are dead.
The ravens had taken the town. Renato had seen villages emptied like this. All the people taken away to be sacrificed in the Emperor's secret rituals. Renato hoped the people were just hiding. Renato's blood was up. He just needed to smash something.
Oh, you should be able to smash that. What's this little thingy? That thing. Wrong sword. Oh. Okay. Oh, come on. Tell me I can't get in these gates? That sucks. Okay. Oh, we're gonna run back then.
He wasn't that good. Yet.
He wasn't that good yet. Use the altar. Can we dash? Can we learn the dash? Oh no, we need another skill point. Dash. Supernatural dash. Okay. We need to kill some more things. Oh, I can go in here, though. Okay, let's go back. Let's head back this... Oh. Oh, yes. Heck yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Getting a little bit of lag. There we go. Alright, fine. 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 We'll go through this door. Stab it. Meow. Why are there gated communities? Okay, let's smash the save up. Nope.
Can't we just agree to disagree? Said Renato. No?
Oh yeah, I'm liking that. Ooh, what? Oh
Ravens
yeah.
We're landing everywhere.
Level 2, baby.
The advance guard. He'd better get moving. If they got to Lupino first, they'd eat him for breakfast.
Oh, or what?
A snack. Ravens weren't picky. If they got hungry, they sometimes forgot to interrogate their prisoners. Even top spies like Lupino. Where had the mad rabbit got to?
All right.
Oh, you shouldn't have.
Oh, you shouldn't have. That's funny. Yeah. Oh, man. Come on. Come on. Give me some ore. Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Give me that ore. Got 18 ore. Not doing too bad. Can I fall down here? Nope. It stops you for a little bit. Okay. It seemed like a waste area. Okay. Come on. All right. Nothing weird about that. What about what's up here? Oh, oh! I didn't even see that over there. Go, 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 go! Another chest. Oh yeah, that's ore for days. 25 ore, almost up to 30. We craft a new sword. We need some essence though if we want to craft like a brand new sword. Okay, I can learn this.
It was starting to come back to him. Something you never completely forgot, like how to freeze time when attacking.
Okay, he said that last time.
The more he'd probably remember.
Dashing consumes stamina. Okay. Ooh. Consumes a lot of stamina. Okay. Alright, let's go. Let's go. Get over here.
Come over here.
Oh. Yeah. Yes, give me another skill. Ah, you suck. I was so close. Oh, I wish you could jump in this game. I would just jump all
Renato
the time.
I felt a chill run down his back. Or possibly a flea.
Oh, we're in the graveyard now. Kind of. Hey, another one of these things. What? Okay. Oh, what's this? Attack immediately when the previous attack hits to land a perfect strike. Bonus damage and double combo. Slow down time after a successful counter until your next action. Take a breather and plan your next move. Countering an attack now causes damage. Ooh, I like that. Increase your maximum health, speed. Okay. I like this right here. That's pretty cool. Especially since I see countering being like a major battle component. Cause you could, it's kind of like Assassin's Creed kind of, where countering can just like make or break you. Like you could just pretty much stand there and counter the entire time and come up with like, you know, 6 or 7 kills. You did.
Renata felt ready to take on new powers.
Okay. I think this, man. I think it's gotta be this. Damage. 5, 10, 15 damage. Or the combo. These only have one. We don't need really any health right now. Speed. I'll put one in it. Let's see. Okay. Oh, his friend. We found him. Found his friend. Can we go over here? No. Can we go back here? Oh. Whoa, I am pretty low on health. So their attacks hurt. What's up, friend?
Dirty and bloody, Renato finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing his shuffle. Renato recognized the cards. It was Lupino's favorite deck.
Oh, I thought you were in danger. I am. The ravens are coming. Oh, the prison thing. Right, yeah, we see this guard owed me 53 ducats, so we made a deal. They're very reasonable people, actually, for weasels. Now, I got a brilliant plan to kidnap Zenobia. We capture Zenobia, we find out what she knows, and that's the whole war right there. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
Capture the Emperor's greatest general, who also happened to be a deadly sorcerer and, oh, his only daughter? That would be worth it. On the other hand, he could still get to the core of the Sky Ripper, even if he couldn't get the whole thing. It must have great power.
I want to see this. I want to stick to this first path. I want to see this because
Zenobia wasn't just the Emperor's daughter, of course. She'd been Renato's best friend in Swordfu school.
And you're still mad for her, the rabbit reminded him.
They'd been close. She'd told him things no one else knew, but she'd never told him who she really was.
She knows all the Emperor's plans, chuckled the Master Spy.
She won't give them up easily.
She'll tell the interrogators all right, said Lupino.
Taking her would change the game all right.
So we gotta take that lady. Take the sorcerer's daughter. The emperor's daughter, who looks like a fox, but the emperor is a toad. Something weird's going on here. Something weird between a toad and a fox. Where's the mother? I want to see the mother.
The city was already under Zenobia's control. I had to admire her efficiency. Renato shivered at the thought of Zenobia at the mercy of the interrogators. Could he really turn her over to them? But this was war. It wasn't meant to be pretty.
Alright guys, that's going to be it for today. We got through chapter 1, looks like. Well, looks like we're on chapter 2. Capture Zenobia. The fox-toad mixture. So we're going to end it right here, but I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a thumbs up, and if you want to see more, leave me a comment down in the comment section. Just let me know what y'all think of the.
Have you ever felt you were just going around in circles? Renato felt like that.
I love it when game developers do that. But leave me a comment. Let me know what you think of the game. Let me know what you think. If you want to see more, just let me know. But as always, y'all have a good day, night, whatever it is for you around the world, and we'll see you next time.